Happy New Year, guys. Woohoo! It's 2016, which means it's an entire new year for movies. Yay! Yay! Yeah, so 2015 was a year that I was not able to see a lot of movies because it was my final semester at Columbia College. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I had a lot of work that I had to do. Mm-hmm. So I wasn't able to see as many movies as I wanted, but now I have time.
Yeah. So rather than do a best of this year podcast, because we didn't see enough to really make a best of or a worst of, we just could kind of make a list of this is what we saw, but like not really definitively say. Brent's just going to share what he's really looking forward to next year. And hopefully we can do a real one next time. And, yeah.
All right. So these are the list of movies that, in no particular order. Except for one, yes. Which I'll reveal first. And that is Silence, directed by Martin Scorsese. Mm-hmm. The book is amazing. I know probably a lot of people listening are not religiously inclined. Silence is a very religious story. It's about Portuguese priests who go to Japan and then are subjected to the religious xenophobia that the Japanese have. Mm-hmm. And they have to overcome serious hardships. And it's starring Liam Neeson, Andy Garfield, and Star Wars' Adam Driver, mm-hmm. which I'm a little skeptical about him as an actor, but...
I think he's a good actor. I know you have an issue with the way he talks.
Yeah. It's possible, but the book is amazing.
So wait, they're Portuguese and like...
None of them are Portuguese. Yeah, yeah.
It's and kind of, probably none of them can actually speak Portuguese.
And they're whitewashed and yeah.
I mean, I'm partly not as much concerned as that as I am of, like, they're not going to have an accent and they're not going to be able to speak the language.
Yeah, I think they're going to throw that over the side, which...
Again?
Yeah, it...
It's a shame because, like, Martin Scorsese in this book, that sounds awesome, but, like...
To be fair, I really like the movie The Last Temptation of Christ, and that movie is totally whitewashed.
There are films and characters that can be good if they're whitewashed, but, like...
The Japanese aren't whitewashed, obviously, but...
No, but, like, there's a historical context at play here.
Yeah, it's problematic, I know, but... Well, really looking forward to...
It's not problematic, necessarily, but it's just, like, the... really heavily religious inclinations of Spanish-speaking countries.
Yeah.
That is like a big cultural thing that could be at play that you're taking
away. Originally, the casting was Benicio Del Toro and Daniel Day-Lewis.
Oh,
and I was like, wow, that's an amazing casting. So, like, this film has gone through, like, several different casting. Mm-hmm. There originally was a much more Spanish-speaking thing. I think...
I'm not going to go to Japan and just find a bunch of white people there, are they?
I forget what the actor is, but there was another, like, Spanish-speaking actor that was, like, supposed to be in it. Mm-hmm. So I'm, like, kind of like, what the fuck, guys? What happened?
What did you do?
Yeah. So, but that being said, I think the movie's going to be amazing.
Well, it's a Scorsese flick. Like,
yeah. So.
Hugo's probably his weakest, and that's not a bad movie by any means.
He's made some weaker films than Hugo, but yeah.
Really? Like what?
I don't know off the top of my head. Oh, Bringing Out the Dead.
Oh, I haven't seen that.
Yeah. So, yeah. But that being said, I'm really looking forward to that, and the source material is so strong that I think it's going to be very hard to fuck up the movie, at least dramatically.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right, so I'm also looking forward to Terrence Malick's new film.
Yay!
Which is Knight of Cups.
Yay!
And it's starring Christian Bale. And Aww. He is... Well, Christian Bale was in The New World.
He was not my favorite part of the New World.
Well, right, but this is a movie about celebrity, which is interesting, but it's also like, you know, this whole like existential crisis thing, which Terrence Malick is very good at. I'm expecting this movie to be as abstract as To the Wonder. I wouldn't be surprised if it goes more abstract than To the Wonder, which is Terrence Malick's latest film, which, I mean, I'll admit, I personally love Tree of Life and To the Wonder, but Terrence Malick is a director that the further his films go in his career, the more abstract they go. So if you're looking for a straight narrative, do not watch this movie.
Well, you don't know that yet.
But I strongly doubt that it's going to be a straight narrative.
I'm just hoping that it's not going to go in the way of Map to the Stars? Map of the Stars?
It's not going to.
Well, I'm just saying, you know, I have a particular bias. I don't really like yuppie movies. I don't really like movies about celebrity.
But at the same time, Terrence Malick is.
But exactly, it's Terrence Malick.
He's not
Terrence
cold.
Malick hasn't made
Terrence
a
Malick
movie.
Is not cold either. And David Cronenberg, who made Match to the Stars, and like
has
other
films,
has
always been very cold.
Yeah, like even the films that I love are cold.
No,
I mean, the warmest
agree.
Film that he made is The Fly.
You know, which is still pretty. I don't think that movie is cold, though. I think that movie is alienating. But there is a certain. Never mind. Just to keep it brief. I don't know what to think about the subject matter. But it's Terrence Malick. He has not made a movie that isn't a 5 9/10 stars for me. So, no way.
No.
I mean, even Martin Scorsese can be like, well, Hugo. Hugo's not a bad movie, but, compared to his other movie. No, not Terrence Malick.
All right, so my next movie is The Witch.
Oh, my God, it looks so cool!
Yeah, it does. I have made tons of criticisms of horror films as of late, and mostly because it's, playing it safe, and, I'm sick and tired of paranormal bullshit. Mm-hmm. And just, I get it. Some people are afraid of fucking ghosts, but there's more to horror than just jump scares and fucking ghosts and poltergeists and shit like that. So, which might be in this movie, but the setting's different. It's set in
different.
Yeah, the setting's very different for a horror film. It's set in the 1800s and
Isn't it in an Amish community?
Yeah.
That's kind of what it looks like. Not Amish, but a Puritan. It looks like a Puritan community.
I get some people will be like, oh, well, that's familiar. The Village, but, I personally like The Village. Give me
was
all the shit you
was
can.
Was The Village a horror movie?
The Village had horror elements to it. M. Night Shyamalan,
I know.
Yeah,
but was it really a horror movie?
No. Okay. And that was kind of people's problem.
But also, it's a movie called The Witch, and you put it in the historically appropriate setting.
Right, right. So,
it's not that much like The Village, I would think. Are there witches in The Village?
No, there's other stuff in it. Okay. But anyways, based on the trailer, which didn't reveal much, which, thank God.
So, yeah, thank you. Can we please get more shit like that? I'm hooked. I'm going to buy my ticket. Can you, not tell me the whole movie now?
Yeah.
How many trailers need a spoiler warning in it? Seriously.
Yeah. just put spoilers.
Spoiler.
Yeah. Because, I don't need to see a Cliff Notes version of every... I mean, there's some movies that I literally don't watch because I see the trailer. Yeah.
Done.
Yeah. All right. So the next movie is a movie that's coming out next week, which is The Revenant.
Okay. I'm going to put my fingers in my ears right now because I have forbidden you to say anything about that. He saw a little bit more of the trailer than I have. I have not seen any bit of the trailer. I do not know anything about the movie. I know the director and the casting, and I've seen the poster. That's all. So I'm going to put my fingers in my ears and let me know when he's done.
All right, so the cinematography looks awesome, and whatever that horse was doing off the cliff, holy shit. Anyways, it looks awesome, and I'll let you know whenever the movie comes out and I see it, and then we'll do a review of it. All right, you can unclose your ears.
Okay.
All right, so my next movie is Deadpool.
Woohoo! Oh my god, I can't freaking wait.
Yeah, I can't wait.
That's gonna be a fun ride.
I can't wait to watch a rated R superhero movie. I mean, I kind of got it with... I mean, granted, there's one movie that I'm gonna force you to watch. That is, I know you're getting sick and tired of superhero movies, but fucking Super.
I'm not sick and tired of superhero movies.
Okay.
I still have a collection of superhero movies, yeah. Like as a specific genre. Or okay. Comic book movies, not superhero yeah. movies. I'm not sick of it in general, which is why I'm excited for Deadpool. I'm just sick of MCU and DCCU.
Which
and
this movie is like,
either of those.
Fuck you.
Yeah. Like, it's the exact antithesis of those. So I'm super excited about that. And all
yeah,
super,
and also a hard
super
R.
Super has been on my list, by the way.
This movie is a hard R.
Yeah.
They have... trailer warnings on top of this movie. There's lots of cussing.
No. The warning is because of that ass. Oh my god. If they don't put a warning on it, you're going to have a freaking heart attack because,
Yeah, but it looks like a lot of fun. And yeah, it's all because of the internet, actually.
Yeah, pretty
because,
much.
Because a trailer leaked out online that everybody loved and then they're like,
oh, shoot, we got to make a movie for this trailer
yeah,
now.
Yeah, so... Here's my hint to anybody working in the Hollywood industry. If you see something that looks awesome and they're just like, nah, leak it.
Yeah. Just
you'll
try
help
it.
Everybody out mm-hmm. by doing that. We're sick and tired of the same shit. Give us shit like this.
Well, also, leaking it is a safe idea because if it doesn't do well, at least you fucking know you didn't waste the time.
Also, I mean, like, I totally admit, Deadpool really isn't a new thing. He's fucking Wolverine and Spider-Man. He's got, like, the fucking, you know, smart-ass thing of Spider-Man. You know, he's got the healing powers of Wolverine, but holy shit, is he a lot more vulgar.
Oh, yeah. And that's what that's...
yeah, and Spider-Man is way too friendly. Family-friendly.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
But that's part of why I actually liked Amazing Spider-Man 2, the Amazing Spider-Man series, was because they made him less of that and more of the smart-ass character that he's supposed to be. When he is in the spider suit, at least. Like, he has some really funny fucking shit that he does. Oh no, a knife! I'm so scared. Anyways, Deadpool. Fuck yes!
Yeah.
Oh, I do have a photo on my cell phone of Ren sitting in Deadpool's lap, very suggestively. You've probably seen those little posters, yeah, maybe we should have, like, a video compilation of, like, people submitting their sitting in Deadpool's lap pictures.
Yeah, so if you sat in Deadpool's lap, send us an email, and we will put it in our Deadpool podcast.
Yeah, definitely.
So, yeah, definitely do that. And yeah. All right, so my next movie is... the new film from Jeff Nichols, who is one of my favorite up-and-coming directors. I actually wrote a paper on Jeff Nichols. And
which I think you should try to release here sometime. It's very good.
I'll work on it, yeah. I mean,
it would take some work to figure out how, but I think that would be a good idea.
Yeah, I'll figure out some way to publish it and see about that.
Yeah.
Put the pressure on me. Wow.
But, well, if I say it, then it must be so.
Yeah. So Jeff Nichols directed three films. His first film, most of you probably haven't heard of. It's called Shotgun Stories. It's kind of like a take on the Hatfield and McCoy's tragedy. Is it mm-hmm. McCoy's or McCoy?
I think it's McCoy singular, okay. But don't quote me. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know. And then his next film, I personally think, is his best film, which is Take Shelter, which is about a man who has apocalyptic visions and
wait,
he's not sure.
Take Shelter came out before Mud?
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah. So, like, and he's not sure if he's crazy and everything like that. And it's amazing. And then his next film
is... Take Shelter is so good.
Yeah. And then his next film, which is a film that... probably is the closest to me as a person. Mud, like, you take the character of Alice and, like, that's a lot of me growing up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, it was kind of interesting to watch something so personal and so close to who I am, you know, on screen. I mean, I usually don't see that. I mean, granted, I heard my name all throughout the movie Star Wars, but it's not
you don't really, you're not that guy.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. All right. So the next movie is...
And, of course, the Jeff Nichols movie that's coming out this year is a movie called Midnight Special, which is kind of a super-powered story. I'm not really sure really what it's about, but it's Jeff Nichols, so I'll definitely watch it.
Something else that's near and dear to me, which is The Jungle Book. I mean, I'm a little skeptical just because it's Disney and all that kind of stuff, but, like...
But Disney did the live-action Jungle Book movie, and it was fucking amazing.
And most adaptations of the Jungle Book have been great. You know what's also been great about Jungle Book adaptations? Never fucking whitewashed.
Well, because there's one human character, and he's Mowgli.
Yeah, but at the same...
You can't have a white Mowgli.
But like, at the same time, you know, like, they could have done a fucking Tarzan thing, where it's like everybody else, you know, but you have that one white guy, you know.
To be fair, they sort of, like... Okay, the casting looks super great for this movie, except for one major thing. And it's the only thing you get in the trailer. Scarlet! Oh, can we have a year where there's no fucking Scarlet, please?
Yeah, Casey is not a fan of Scarlet.
You're not a fan of Scarlet either!
No, I'm not, but like... I think as a voice actor, she's not that like grating. Like, look at her.
I disagree.
Look at her. She was fine in her.
I still like
her. She
the
was
other
the voice of Sam...
Samantha, I know, but like, even that... I'm sick of her playing the same thing where she's this non-humanoid... usually ass-kicking type of whatever the fuck, because she's not very good at it.
Well, she's not going to be ass-kicking as Ka.
No, but she's still like this non-humanoid, like, seductive, whatever the fuck. She's a lot... I saw her in Chef as the girlfriend on the side, and I was amazed by how likable
she was.
You
haven't even seen this fucking movie, so you don't know if she's going to be, like, that prominent or, like, that annoying.
No, but I was still just like... No, part of it is I'm like, can we have a year without her so then I don't have to, like... hear her and see her every time I go to the theater. Because, you know, it's all the trailers and she's in like a million movies a year and whatever the fuck. And I'm just like...
Okay, but I'm looking forward
aside,
to this.
That aside, the casting looks good and the way that they have it set up is good. Yeah. Like, I really like it. She's the only talking character. I don't think she's going to be. But in the trailer, they have her being able to talk in the character, and I like that.
They do have, like, each character has a voice actor to it.
No,
so,
I know, because it's a big cast, but I wonder if they're, like, gonna downplay the, like, oh, we're friendly talking animals. Maybe a little bit more cerebral? I don't know.
Possibly, but I do believe that the animals are actually going to talk.
Yeah,
like,
but
kind of
like
what they
minimal.
Did with... Kind of like what they did with Babe, except it's not real animals. It's, you know, CGI. Yeah. But, you know, it looks interesting.
It looks super cool.
And we still will get another...
It visually looks good.
And if that's not good, we'll still get another Jungle Book. Because apparently Andy Serkis is still doing a Jungle Book that's not related to this one. So, you know, there's that. So if that one sucks, you know, at least we'll have another one. Or that one could suck.
Yeah. To be fair, I don't know what I think about Andy Serkis as a director yet. He was second unit director for the Hobbit movies and like that whatever. But like I've seen his movie that he directed. I've seen part of it. I haven't seen the whole thing.
What movie
but,
is that?
Fuck, I cannot think of what it's called now. I'm sure if you like Google it, you can find it. It's on his like biography and whatever. I saw part of it and I was a little disappointed because I hold Andy Serkis to such a high standard as an actor. So, I mean, whatever. I didn't see the whole thing and that's probably part of it, but I don't know.
Okay. All right. So, my next movie is Kubo and the Two Strings.
Oh my God, the look of it. Oh.
Yeah, it's nice to see, like, stop-motion animation, like, actually, like, having some kind of resurgence.
Well, of course. Like, people keep trying to tell me at film school, oh, but stop-motion's dead. Stop-motion's dead. people don't do this anymore. Wasn't it cool back in the day? And I'm like, what the fuck are you guys talking about? Yeah, I mean, this was the year Fantastic Mr. Fox came out, too.
Yeah, and you have Paranorman. Paranorman, Box Trolls.
This new Omnilesia, where there was some Marion other Max is another recent one, recent-ish, recent enough. Yeah. And
Animalosa,
that's what I'm trying to think of. I can't ever say the name, but that's coming out too. And it's not fucking dying, you guys.
Yeah.
Fuck off.
All right, and so my next movie that I'm really hyped for is Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, The Sword of Destiny. And the reason why I'm excited for this movie is because Michelle Yeoh is returning. And she was awesome in the original. Plus, Zhang Zi is returning as well. So you have the actors from the original. And also, Donnie Yen is coming on to this one. And if you're a fan of martial arts movies, holy shit. I haven't seen any trailers, but I know that there's a continuation to the Crouching Tiger story because it's actually based on something.
Right.
I'm really interested to see where it goes. And I actually, because I loved the original movie by Ang Lee so much, I actually went out and read some of the manhwa based off of the novel. And yeah, the story's pretty interesting as it gets further. So that'll be really fun to see. So,
all right, so that's a list of the films that I'm looking the most forward to. If you want to hear some of the films that I'm speculating about for next year, click on the link below and check it out. Also, the full podcast will be later put on YouTube as well as podbean.com, which will just have the whole conversation that we had about the year 2016. Thanks for listening.
All right, so the next list of movies that I have are movies that I'm interested in, but I'm kind of questioning whether or not they'll be good.
Now, Crouching Tiger. I disagree with you about, by the
now,
way.
Now, Crouching Tiger is one of those movies that I'm just it could be good, it could be bad, just because Netflix is producing it, and I don't know. It's like.
But, what are some of these ones on your list? I'm looking at it now and I'm just like, some of these do not belong on your maybe list because they're definitely going
to
be good.
I had to pick up.
And some of these should not be on there because you know they're going
to
be shit.
Well, I had to pick. Let me explain myself.
Or not because you know they're going to be shit, but okay, Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them? Why are you interested in that?
Hey, the movie might be good, actually. So, let me...
Oh, you're interested in it because of the casting. That's why.
Well, let me explain myself with each one. You're spoiling things.
Well, because I'm reading it now.
All right. So, the first one is Trespass Against Us, which has Michael Fassbender, Domino, and Brendan Gleeson. So, and it's...
Who's Brendan Gleeson again?
Brendan Gleeson was in Bruges.
Oh, yay!
So, I don't
that
really...
That guy, yeah.
I don't really know much about the movie, but, you have those two people, and I'm
And it's an interesting title, and you will watch anything that has Michael Fassbender in it, including Assassin's Creed, which is also on your list only because it's got Michael Fassbender in it.
Yeah, so I'll go next. I'll go next with Assassin's Creed. It's got Michael Fassbender. Fuck the video games. I don't play them. They're long. They're boring. They come out every year, and, granted... Some of them might be interesting. I played the first one. Didn't like it. It's very repetitive.
But you have Michael Fassbender, so you'll be happy.
And, exactly.
And your pants will be happy, too.
Oh, my God. All right, so the next movie is Godzilla Resurgence.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
Fuck me for not putting that in my top 10.
Not putting it in your top 10, but the maybe? That's just going to be fucking awesome.
Well, the reason why I put it
Shin Godzilla.
The reason why I put Shin Godzilla or Godzilla Resurgence into my maybe is because the production company working on it worked on the terrible Attack on Titan movies.
No, but the production in Attack on Titan
But I don't know who the director is either. The director is a fucking nobody either. And plus the video that we got was kind of that shaky cam stuff. So I don't know. It could be good. It could be bad. It's Godzilla. I'll fucking watch it. It will be better than the 2014.
Okay, yes. But the design of Godzilla looks fucking awesome. It's going to be a mix of suits, miniatures, and CGI,
yeah, which is probably going to look fucking awesome. I'm going to like it, but it didn't get on my top 10.
Okay, that's but I will say this officially once and for all. Yes, the writing for the Attack on Titan movie is garbage, but the Titans look amazing. If they can make the kaiju look that, I mean, because Titans are kaiju, let's not joke for a second, yeah. But you know, if he could be that fucking amazing, I mean, goddamn. Yeah. But that's true. I mean, like, the script for Attack on Titan fucking blew.
Yeah. All right, so the next movie is Loving Vincent.
Which I'm interested in, too, because I'm a big-time Vincent fan.
Yeah, it is a Vincent Van Gogh animated movie.
It's Which I think is the way to go, really.
It's a biographical...
biographical.
It's a biographical movie on Vincent Van Gogh, and... I don't know what it's going to be rated, but if it's anything like rated lower than PG-13, I'll be skeptical of. So once I see
look at his life, I mean.
Yeah, his life is R, like, period.
Yeah.
So
if you're really going to do it justice.
Yeah, so I'm going to hold off that, you know, my skepticism is because of what it's going to be rated in, like, the context and everything like that. They might sugarcoat it.
But to be fair, Amnesia or whatever is rated R.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you can't have an animated movie that's rated R.
Yeah, but that's one movie.
No, I know, but it could happen.
Right. Okay.
But maybe.
All right, so my next movie is Cowboy Ninja Viking.
What the fuck?
And this is a movie that sounds really interesting because it's a guy who actually has delusions and multiple personalities that he believes that he's a cowboy, a ninja, and a Viking. And it stars Chris Pratt. So
that seriously sounds like that episode of South Park where everybody thinks Butters has multiple personalities and he's just playing make-believe that he's Firefighter Butters, you know, and that sort of thing. But Chris Pratt, he's just so funny.
Yeah. So I don't know. I don't know if the movie's going to be good or not. It has Chris Pratt in, so I'll probably watch it. All right, my next movie, I... left off my list, but I'm a little skeptical about it just because of that PG rating before. I'm afraid they'll do a PG-13 and sugarcoat it, but it is The Legend of Conan, which has Arnold Schwarzenegger coming back, not fucking Khal Drogo, who fucked it up. Which, how the fuck did he fuck it up? Yes, there was a Khal Drogo, Jason Momoa Conan movie that they fucked up. And it was PG-13.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, that one.
Yeah,
I didn't realize that was Khal Drogo in it. That's why I was confused.
Yeah, because he didn't have the fucking beard. But yeah,
pretty much.
But
pretty much. You don't have the beard, I don't fucking know who the hell you are.
but anyways, it's fucking Conan returned by Arnold Schwarzenegger. And, like, I mean, like, what else could you ask for?
And
an R rating and tits. That's it.
I'm going to say this,
too. And more punching of camels.
Yes, more punching of camels. But I'm going to say this real quick. Some people have been like, what the fuck, Arnold Schwarzenegger's old. I like old Arnold Schwarzenegger.
I like old Arnold Schwarzenegger, too.
I think he's really likable now. I mean, there's just something about him I really dig now that he's older. And he's not like a... oh, whatever, I'm a secret world. No, I don't mean like that. There's just something about him that, like, I want to watch that movie.
Yeah. All right, so the next movie is The Great Wall. And the reason why I put The Great Wall on this list is because it's directed by the same guy who did Hero and House of Flying Daggers. So here's one thing that you know the movie will have. Absolutely fucking gorgeous cinematography.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's really all that you have to sell me on.
Okay,
so,
moving on.
So, yeah. All right, so the next movie I have to put on this list as...
Why?
I have to put it on the list as a question because...
This is a question on my list. Why the fuck is this on your list?
Why is it on... Because, you know, I'm a fan of Tim Burton's earlier work. But... You know,
Mrs. me, so fuck off.
Mrs. Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children might be good Tim Burton, or it might be the same shit that we've been seeing for a long time. It's live action, so I'm skeptical.
Why the fuck is this on your list? Don't even act like you're more into Tim Burton than I am.
That's why I put it on. Well, that's why I put it in the question mark. Like, it might be good.
This is a question mark for me too, is because I have the book series and I haven't read them yet. I got them rather recently, so I mean, the books always looked really interesting to me, but I never quite picked them up. And then, you know, I hear like, oh, there's gonna be a Tim Burton movie coming out, and for a while, him being attached to this movie was part of my proof that after Frankenweenie that he was on the resurgence and he was like going back to his roots. And then he came out with Big Eyes and I'm like, you managed to walk the direct line between good and bad. What the hell? I don't even know what to make of you anymore. And then there's like Beetlejuice 2 that's supposedly going through instead of him making the kaiju movie that he was supposed to do. And I'm like, what the fuck, Burton? But also, he's such an asshat, and he's really one of those directors that, like, really became too old to be cool. There's not an age limit attached to too old to be cool. It's a state of mind. But Tim Burton really hit that, and he's, like, not aging well as a director, not, like, as a person. I don't give a fuck. No. But I'm really not talking about, like, what he looks like or anything, but, like, he feels like an old director now.
Yeah, he has old director syndrome.
Yeah, and not everybody gets it. You know, Martin Scorsese is doing great.
Well, if you're George a fucking Miller cinephile, or if you're really passionate about your shit, you don't get old director syndrome because it's not a job to you. It's a passion.
Right. And Tim Burton, he could do biographical shit very well.
Yeah.
And even Helena Bonham Carter called him out on it one time and it was fucking hilarious. But he could do autobiographical shit really well. And as soon as he has to get outside of that, he doesn't know what the fuck to do. And now that he's grown out of his angsty teenage years that lasted from when he was 6 until he was like 36, you know, now all of a sudden he doesn't know what the fuck to do anymore. What's he gonna write about? A movie where he gets divorced and calls his son a faggot? And I'm like, what the hell?
Yeah.
Sorry about that, but that's actually a thing that happened. Or according to Helena Bonham Carter, he said that about his son because his son likes Judy Garland.
Yeah.
He's an asshat, is my point. Oh yeah, I never read comics, Kevin Smith. And it's like, the fuck you did? You made Batman. I truly did not believe he's never read a comic book, and he made the first Batman movie. Batman Returns does not seem like he ever read the comics, but Batman? Fuck him.
Alright, so the next movie I absolutely am going to see. It would have been on my list, but, you know, I could only pretend. Right. Zootopia. This movie looks hilarious, and they actually gave us an entire scene.
And it was funny!
Yeah! Oh like, my god.
I was kind of skeptical when I saw it and I was like, Frozen. Oh, fuck. And then we saw this scene and I'm like, well, that entertained me more than the entirety of the movie Frozen.
Entertained me more than some of the Pixar movies lately. And I was just like, what the fuck? Yeah, like, this feels
like a Pixar movie.
This feel well.
I mean, it looks like a Pixar movie, not a Disney movie.
Yeah, it looks good. The humor is funny.
Yeah.
Like, they gave us a trailer. They gave us one trailer, and then they gave us a scene, which I like trailers like that better. You know, it's like of these fucking sloths at the DMV, and like she's trying to tell them a joke, and they're just like, oh my god. Yeah, it looks like a great family movie.
And that Pets movie is on my list. Part of it looks like kind of corny, and part of it really made me laugh. The wiener dog underneath the beater who's like massaging himself was so cute. And the
all right, so this movie is called The Secret Life of Pets.
That's it. I don't fucking know. And then there's like this prissy looking poodle with a pink collar, and his name's Leonard. And his owner likes to play classical music, and he's like, "Goodbye, Leonard, I'm leaving." And as soon as his owner leaves, he switches the music and starts headbanging to death metal. I'm like, "Yes!"
So it's kind of like a Toy Story slash,
but with pets. Well, I just love that because, you know, you see some animals like that, and you're like, "Oh my god, the animal cannot be happy with their owner doing this to them." And like with the poodle, you really get that, and I thought that was so funny.
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, that movie's on my list of, like, questions, you know, just
well,
because...
Well, also on two.
Yeah. So, another movie that, like, I'm really looking forward to, but, like, a little skeptical about just because it's a prequel, and that is The Huntsman, Winter's War. Kind of a dumb title, but, like, holy shit. Like, this movie has, like, my wet dream.
Well, I was going to say, I wanted to see this movie before I even knew what the fuck movie it was, because I saw the posters, and I was like, it's three of the four most gorgeous women in Hollywood put together in a movie.
Yeah.
Oh my fucking God. Yeah,
you got Charlize Theron, Jessica Chastain, and Emily Blunt. I mean, like who wouldn't want to have that foursome? And then you got the guy that
won't Oh, fuck swim. That guy. Nobody gives a shit about that guy. Why would you give a shit about
fucking
that?
Thor. No. That's fucking Thor. No, you can take,
fuck Thor.
No, here's the thing. Fuck you can Thor. Take your girlfriend. You can take your girlfriends to see this movie because they'll be like, oh my God, Thor's so hot.
No, fuck You're, Thor when you have Jessica Chastain in tight leather. Yes.
Yeah, and her ass is very prominent in that poster.
Well, they all look fucking amazing. And Emily Blunt has always been gorgeous. Like, Live, Die, Repeat. Holy shit, is she hot. And it's because she's buff. I mean, she's not buff, but she's toned and is super fucking sexy. And, I mean, Charlize Theron.
Yeah.
Okay, how ugly can you make Charlize Theron before she becomes unattractive? You can't. It's impossible.
Except Monster.
Ugh. No. Fuck that. No.
You need to watch that movie.
No, I know, but like in the trailers and in the poster at least, I'm still just like, you look like shit and you're fucking gorgeous. God damn it. Cry.
Yeah, so I mean, like, I don't know if this movie is gonna be good, but like I normally am not one of those people that's like, oh, but the women are hot, but like they're also good actresses. So,
right. Yeah. I mean, that's half of the reason why they're so hot. It's not their looks.
I mean, it is their looks, but it's also their performances.
No, they're beautiful, but if they were just beautiful and they acted like shit, they would be on the Megan Fox train where it's like, well, bye-bye, I'm not interested, you know?
Yeah. All right, so then I have The Legend of Tarzan, which I'm skeptical about this movie, partly because I've never seen a Tarzan movie.
Right, so, including the Disney one.
Yeah, so I'm skeptical about it, and I know that they've tried to make, like, other Tarzan movies and recent Tarzan movies and stuff like that, and they've been unsuccessful. But I saw the trailer, and it looked pretty good, so I'm looking forward to this one. I'll see what it is. I mean, it could go one way, it could go the other. But, I mean, what do you have?
I don't fucking know. I haven't seen the trailer yet, so...
Okay, trailer looks good. I'll show you after this.
I honestly don't particularly care. Tarzan was not really particularly anything to me growing up, except for it was kind of dark. And then the anime movie didn't particularly... I mean, like, the story doesn't...
You have Alan Skarsgård, who was really the best part of True Blood, and that actor himself is good. Well, yeah, but that actor himself is good. So, like, I truly think that this might be what gets me into Tarzan.
Okay.
No. All right, so then the next movie I have is Warcraft. The trailer actually looked pretty good.
It looks really good until you see that it's a World of Warcraft movie, and then you're like, wait, what the fuck?
Yeah, and I'm sorry for World of Warcraft fans or Warcraft fans that, you know, like the games before, you know, right. Real-time strategy game. Like, it turned from a real-time strategy game to, like, the most successful.
No, I didn't necessarily mean, like... Oh, the fucking World of Warcraft movie. But it doesn't look like the video game cash grab movie. Like Prince of Persia or Assassin's Creed. It looks like a really good movie. And then you're like, wait, this is a video game cash in? What the fuck is this?
Yeah, but I'm skeptical because it's a video game movie.
Like, well, I thought it was super interesting that they were like following a family of orcs. Like a family of orcs. That was interesting.
Yeah, that's interesting. I'm on board with that. I'm on board with it too, but like the movie has to be good, and this looks like a movie that could go both ways.
Yes.
Yeah, like easily, and plus I really like the actor who plays in the show Vikings, who's the main character. Yeah.
Yay.
Yeah. So.
Ragnar
Lothbrok is his name in the show.
I'm so fucking easy to please. I'm like, everybody's attractive. Yeah. Everybody makes me happy.
All right, so the next film that I have on my list of like this questionable thing is Oliver Stone's new movie. Oliver Stone is a director that, you know, always kind of likes to push the button of, you know, controversy. I mean, he's done things from, you know, Natural Born Killers. He did Wall Street. And now he's doing Snowden. Mm-hmm. The reason why I'm a little skeptical about this movie is because W was okay, you know, which was a film about George W. Bush.
No, I remember W.
He also did World Trade Center, which was, like, really terrible.
I didn't see that one.
Yeah, so I'm just really skeptical because, like, Oliver Stone, he's not been so hot lately. All right, so the next movie is... Independence Day Resurgence.
What the fuck, dude?
I don't know. Independence Day is a guilty pleasure for me. This might be a guilty pleasure for me.
Wait. Is it because of Will Smith?
No, it's not. Welcome to Earth.
Okay, then fuck off.
Like, no, here's the thing.
Get the fuck out right now.
Dude, it's fucking Randy Quaid, man.
Who?
Randy Quaid.
Who?
Hello, boys. I'm back.
Get the fuck out of here right now.
The fucking redneck, dude.
No, I know who you're talking about. Get out.
Oh, God. No, I am not getting out. Anyways, so this movie might be good. It might be fun. It does have Jeff Goldblum again. And I know you don't like Jeff Goldblum. Watch The Fly again. Anyways.
No, I like him in The Fly, but other than that, like, as an actor, like, as an appealing, like, oh, sell me on it, just, like, gag.
I don't know. Independence Day could be good. It could be shit.
My favorite role that Jeff Goldblum ever played was the one where I couldn't fucking see him. That was Prince of Egypt, guys.
Oh, when he played Aaron?
Yeah, he plays Aaron.
Yeah. All right, so the next movie is Roald Dahl, a live-action adaptation of Roald Dahl's The BFG, The Big Friendly Giant.
Which really, Roald Dahl, like, based on the past of live-action adaptation of Roald Dahl movies, really could go either way. What? Matilda. Ew. Fuck that.
Some people are nostalgic about that movie. I don't get why, but yeah.
If somebody should be nostalgic about that movie, it should be me. And I can look at that honestly and be like, fuck that movie. But, you know, you've got that. You've got Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, which is amazing. But then you also have Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, which fucking blows. And then what else is there?
James and the Giant Peach, which is like, exactly. But the book's amazing.
Like, the book's amazing, but, like, the movie is So you've got, like, two shitty ones and one in a great one. Like, this could really go any direction.
Yeah, so, I mean, I saw the trailer. It looked cute. Mm-hmm. So, there's a possibility of that. Next movie is the movie that we can't pronounce, Amarillosa.
I don't know anybody who's talking about it by name anyways. Like, I don't mean reviewers. I mean, like, people we talk to. They're always like, oh, that new stop-motion animated movie that's coming out. You know, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. Created by Charlie Kaufman, who's, like, a famous writer. He did...
Which is why this movie is getting so much pre-hype. Yeah. Is because, like...
Well, and it was also kickstarted, too.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Like, this...
I was wondering how Starburn Industry, like... feature film became so prominent, and well, I guess man, that's why.
Kickstarter can do a lot of stuff, and like that.
Part of the reason why I'm really interested in this movie is because of Starburn Industries, because they're on my list of studios I would like to apply for a job working for. They do 2D and 3D animation, stop motion stuff a lot of the time, and they were founded by Columbia College Chicago alumni, and they hire a lot of CCC kids, so, you know.
Yeah. Alright, so the next movie that is a question mark on my list is a movie that I hate the production design for, but I think the casting's good, and that is Suicide Squad.
Right, we've kind of talked this to death a million times before anyways, but there's nothing in the trailer that grabs me. The Joker looks like shit, and it's not because of Jared Leto. I'm sure Jared Leto is fine.
Yeah, I'm sure his performance is
good. His lines are crap. His look is fucking horrible.
Like
his tattoos are shit. It looks like
the idea for the Joker was, wait, let's combine Marilyn Manson with Eminem.
You know what it looks like? It looks like that song from Dookie where he is singing about his buddy. You know, I remember way back when, now that I'm on the spot, I can't think of the lyrics, but it's like, you know, I used to be just like like you, but now I'm looking at you and I feel sick and I want to go home. That song. It looks like Billy Joe's
Sick and I want to go home.
I know all the songs on that album by heart, but like I can't think of it at the moment because I'm on the spot. But anyways, it looks like his shitty wannabe friend that he looks at and he's like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Like, he really looks like that guy.
Yeah, so, you know, it could go either way.
I'm also, like, really holding out because I've been really wanting more Harley, live-action Harley, and I hate the shit that's been coming out lately. I don't like new Harley, and I'm not talking about the comics because it's not part of her, like, more prevalent image. I'm talking about, like, the Arkham games. I'm talking about, like, Lolly Harley.
Well, yeah, fuck, I mean, they completely abandoned the idea of Harley Quinn being a Harlequin in any way, shape, or form.
Right, they abandoned this idea that she was ever studying psychology.
Well, they do actually have that in the trailer if you pay close
attention. No, I know they have it in the trailer. I'm saying, like, in, like, the Arkham games and the promotional shit.
Yeah.
You know, they...
No, it's in the Arkham games.
It is?
Yeah, it's there.
Okay. Yeah. I just feel like they make her, like, so fucking stupid now. And she wasn't Jesus stupid. Christ. She was an airhead. There's kind of a difference. She was... No, she was an airhead, but she wasn't, like, fundamentally unintelligent.
Okay.
If that makes sense. I mean, I just think she's too stupid
I still would have loved to see Harley Quinn in the Nolan universe.
I mean, I wanted that for a really long time, and then I really wanted them to do that when Joker died. Like, she was a big fangirl of his, and she erects a Suicide Squad to, like, take up his mantle. I really wanted...
I don't see Chris Nolan doing that, though.
Well, here's the reason why
shit female characters.
That's exactly why I'm retroactively like, no, don't fucking touch Harley. It's because Chris Nolan can't write women for shit. And he proved that with Dark Knight Rises with Anne Hathaway's fucking character. And it's not a slam on Anne Hathaway, but whoever the fuck that was, because it sure as hell wasn't Catwoman or Selena Kyle, was fuck you.
No. Alright, so my next movie is Rogue One. Yeah, I don't like Gareth Edwards, but it's Star Wars, and Gareth Edwards is not Star Wars. So, like...
Edwards not fucking anything. Fuck that guy.
Yeah. Well, I do actually want to watch Monsters just to see if I can give the guy a little bit more props. You know, because that's his best reviewed movie.
Mm-hmm.
So, actually, I think Godzilla might be better reviewed.
Ew!
So, but, you know, I want to see it just...
Reviews don't always mean anything, though.
Well, yeah, I mean, there are plenty of movies that I love that are, like, 50% on Rotten Tomatoes or...
And then, like, what, It Follows had you so pumped and then, like, ugh.
Yeah. Apologies for people who liked It Follows.
Nope.
We didn't.
I'm not going to apologize. No. It Follows was boring.
Yeah, we did a podcast on it. And it doesn't make any sense. And if you want to hear our beef on it, it's there.
Yeah. I mean, It Follows was something that... It had potential, but... I'm not going to sell a movie on potential.
Yeah.
It fucked.
Alright, and... Alright, so
okay,
the next...
Okay, now you've got to, like, fucking... Okay. Yeah, so... Neither one of us are into Harry Potter. Like, into. I've read every book multiple times. I've seen all the movies. I own Fantastical Beasts and Where to Find Them. And I used to have it memorized. That was, like, my favorite one of the series. And it's a fucking glossary, guys, okay? The book is a glossary.
Which
and it's
means...
Like, it's like a trade magazine thing.
Which means there's plenty of room for the movie to actually play around with. They
no,
don't have to be
you're
slaves.
You're not interested in it for that. You like the guy who's in it.
What, the Eddie Redmayne?
Yeah.
Well, he's a good actor.
Well, yeah. There's no disputing that, of course.
Yeah, I mean, Colin Farrell could go both ways.
Well, yeah, he's not... He's always great, but he's not always great.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like J.K. Rowling's wrote her series, and now she's like, I've got to do more stuff. I've got to do more stuff. Oh, shit. What am I going to do now? Well, I wrote this other... I don't even think she wrote it. I know she wrote the screenplay. I think she wrote the screenplay for the new movie, but I don't think she even wrote the Fantastical Beasts Nowhere to Find Them. I might be wrong. Don't quote me, guys. I'm sorry. But,
it's not your thing.
It's just cool. Not my thing. And I don't mind people who are Potterheads. That's cool. But I'm just like... Why is this on your list?
I will say...
It feels like a cash grab to me. It's just like...
It does feel like a cash grab, but I'm hoping... That's why I put it in my question mark. Like, it could be a good movie, it could be a bad movie.
I didn't see anything about it that was particularly appealing, though, besides, you know, the briefest glimpse of Colin Farrell, who's always a sight for sore eyes for me, but other than that, nothing sold. Why the fuck does it look like Hunger Games? It doesn't even look like Harry Potter. Like, the production design of the original series. It looks like Hunger Games.
Because Hunger Games make money.
Yeah. It's fucking weird. I don't like that.
Yeah, well, also, I think it, like, takes place in the U.S. I know. Looking at your face, yeah. But I think, like, they're like, trying to, like, expand the universe of, like...
But wasn't everybody in the British?
Yeah, but,
wasn't
like...
Wasn't everybody in the trailer British?
No, but, like, in... Yeah. But I think they're coming
British?
From... Yes.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay.
Yeah, because fucking every actor is British.
No, I know, but like, that's what I thought.
Yeah. Once again, my apologies to British people. Just, like, yeah, it seems like all the prominent actors are British. I'm just calling it up.
I don't have an issue with, like, there being British people. My issue is when, like, there's people who are in countries that are not the UK, and they're British.
Yeah.
Like, Germans don't sound British. They sound German.
To be fair, Michael Fassbender is Irish. He sounds Irish.
Yeah.
So, you know.
And that's fine. I'm just saying, like, that's my issue. My issue is with British people. I don't even have a problem with British people coming in and doing American accents. My problem is that Hollywood really thinks, if you're not in America, you must sound British.
Yeah.
That's fucking dumb. Unless you actually are British.
Yeah, at least with Schindler's List, they tried to have...
Yeah, with Schindler's List, that's an example of how to do it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So... But, anyways, it might be good. It might be fun. It might just be a cash grab.
This one I can't believe is in your question mark.
My question
is... It's in my question mark, but why is it in your question mark?
What? X-Men Apocalypse?
Yeah. Oh, I know why.
Because Oscar Isaac is... Jubilee, too. But
why are you bringing
Oscar Isaac, this whole thing about, like, you know, oh, I'm the god and all this kind of stuff, and the fact that, like... This movie has
that
a bridge.
That makes sense in, like, mythology of... I mean, like, I get the idea.
Yeah, I mean, I get the idea. Some of the costume choices are kind of...
Oh, well.
Yeah.
We shall see, won't we?
We shall see. I will say that the trailer had me intrigued, but I personally like Matthew Vaughn with X-Men movies.
Me too.
Versus Bryan Singer, who's now coming back to X-Men.
I agree.
Matthew Vaughn, like, X-Men First Class versus X-Men Days of Future Past, which had some issues.
No, you brought it up. You and I are the only people on the face of the planet, I bet, who actually like First Class more.
Really?
I have not met a... Usually when I try to say, but I don't even try to say it's better. Usually I'm like, oh, I happen to prefer First Class. People get pissed. People get really pissed at me. They're like, oh, fuck you. Days of Future Past is the best one. X-Men will never be better than that. Blah, 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 blah. And I'm like,
seriously?
Wait,
but you
what?
Have this whole character arc. You have this
I
whole
agree.
Character arc in, you know, with Xavier and Magneto. Like, it's tragic. Like, and the whole thing with him and Kevin Bacon.
I agree.
Mm, wow. Seriously?
I have not met a single other person besides you who likes First... I mean, I'm sure there might be people on the podcast, but I'm talking about, like... Oh, let's talk about whatever, blah, blah, blah. Never. They get really upset when I try... I don't even try to, like, convince them, oh, but it's better because of this. I'm just like, I like it better. And people are like... And part of it is because I'm not super passionate about X-Men. Let's be honest for a second. I'm not really going to, like, fight to the death about X-Men. But, like, I will with, like, other things.
Mad Max. You know?
Yes. But and other things. But I just get amazed by how much people are like, no, fuck you! Days of Future Past! I'm like, whoa, okay.
Yeah, except Magneto has somehow the magical power to, like, manipulate metal in ways that are not real.
This is not plausible to the world that they created. This is one of those things where it's kind of like the crossblade where, like, I've heard people try to argue, and I'm not sure how true this is or not, where, oh, but scientifically it could happen because of this, this, and this, but I think there's a certain thing where even if it is possible... If it seems very implausible at first glance, maybe you shouldn't use it.
Yeah. Yeah, so, I mean, because of the implausibility, I think that there are some issues with
Really, the reason why I really think the reason why Days of Future Past was Quicksilver. People fucking love Quicksilver, and I fucking love Quicksilver. Quicksilver is awesome, and I'm not saying Days of Future Past isn't awesome. I'm just saying I think First Class is the best one out of all the X-Men movie ever.
Yeah,
that one's my favorite.
Also, the one thing that I am kind of glad about this movie is, from the trailers, no Wolverine.
Well, yeah, because What's-His-Face has been retired. Like, he's retiring from Wolverine, and I'm just like, thank fucking God. And yeah, before you get on my case, it's not because I don't like Hugh Jackman as Wolverine.
Well, I love Hugh Jackman as Wolverine. But
every
like,
X-Men movie ever is a Wolverine movie.
Yeah,
I don't know why he had two origin movies.
Yeah, why can't you just call... I mean, like, honestly, with most of the X-Men movies, except Days of... except First Class, you could literally call them Wolverine and the X-Men. Because that's essentially what the movies are.
Right, and I mean, I get why there were two origin movies, because the first one was so bad that you had to immediately turn around and correct it. But why did you have to have his origin come out first when he's the star of every fucking movie? And why have you done no other origin movies? You're just like...
Also, I'm scared because apparently, like, one of my favorite actors right now, they're heavily hinting and trying to seduce him to become the new Wolverine, and that's Tom Hardy. They're trying to make Tom Hardy.
Tom Hardy and Nicholas Hoult together again!
Oh my God, no. No, no. Yes! We don't need more.
Yes!
Okay. The only way that I'll be okay with Wolverine like coming back is like, okay, Channing Tatum's gonna be the new Gambit. Like, Wolverine and Gambit have like this rivalry that's hilarious in the comic books, and I'd love to see that put on screen.
Right.
And not this fucking Taylor Kitsch thing that we got in
X-Men
Origins.
I want to see more fucking Beast, because, and it's not because he's Nicholas Hoult, because really, I feel very iffy about Nicholas Hoult outside of Mad Max. Beast has always been my favorite X-Men. It's been Beast and Mystique are like my two favorites.
Do you think
I want to see more Beast.
Do you think he's going to choose his like final form in this one, or do you think... like he's gonna be?
I don't think he's really ever gonna be that front and center. I don't know that it'll happen.
I mean, they did it in the third. No, they did it in the third.
No, but
one,
like
yeah.
with the new
with Kelsey
series.
Grammer, yeah. But
no, it's a new series. I don't know if they're ever gonna get to that point because there's.
Well, technically, that film counts in canon.
No, you're right. I just prefer to imagine that it doesn't. I'm gonna focus on the new one, the new X-Men franchise.
And then they made an entire movie to try to correct that.
Ugh.
Yeah.
But I want to see more Beast. But I don't think I will.
Yeah. All right, so my next movie is a question. And I know you might go, really? That's a question? But yes, it is a question. It is the new movie by the Coen brothers called Hail Caesar. And it's all about the inner workings of the Hollywood industry. The Coen brothers usually make great movies. And I can usually count on them. But
usually,
but there are a couple slip ups at the
end.
Yes,
I'm just
the Lady Killers.
I never saw that.
Oh,
how early in their career was that?
Oh, that was later.
Oh, that's not
yeah, it's Tom Hanks and the Wayans brothers.
Okay.
Like, what the fuck, right? But
to be weird, I saw this on your list, and I was like, what is that? And you said a Coen Brothers movie, and I'm like, what the fuck? Why haven't I heard about that?
Yeah, and it stars everybody's favorite, George Clooney.
Oh.
Who was in,
Oh
Brother, Where Art Thou, which was another Coen Brothers movie. And that one was alright, so, I mean... It's a Coen Brothers comedy, which sometimes their comedies are a little bit more divisive. I kind of like when they teeter the line between, you know, comedy and drama.
Mm-hmm.
This looks more on the comedy level, so,
mm-hmm.
you know, it could go both ways. Now, this is for the most fun part. Movies that we think are most likely going to be bad. My number one. I don't think any... I think this movie will probably get worst movie of the year. Gods of Egypt.
This movie looks like a... This movie literally looks 10 years old. This looks like a movie that was going to come out in the early 2000s.
And, like, I can talk all I want about the whitewashing and everything like that. You've probably heard
everybody's it. Everybody's fucking talking about
you've
it.
You've probably heard it. Whitewashing fucking sucks. And look at Pan. It doesn't make you money.
No, it doesn't.
So, you know,
people
on top
voting
of that.
With their wallet. You know, Aloha didn't do that well either.
Yeah.
And that was like almost like that wasn't really even anything you could tell in the trailers, but it got so much shit afterwards for you wrote a Hawaiian character specifically to write a Hawaiian character and you cast a white chick.
Yeah.
What the hell? Like, yeah. That wasn't like wiggle room or whatever, you know?
Yeah. But, this movie looks like shit.
I mean, it looks like shit besides the whitewash.
It looks like a January movie.
It doesn't even look like that. This seriously looks like a 12-year-old movie.
Though, let's face it, this January looks amazing because fucking nobody wants to compete with Star Wars.
Back.
I mean, that's going to be the thing. January is going to be the new fucking month that everything awesome comes out.
Mm-hmm.
Which I'm happy because it's my birthday month. So, yeah. And that's one of the things I always hated about my birthday month was it was like, oh, great, shit movies. Every once in a while.
You want a movie for your birthday? What the fuck are you going to watch?
I mean, every once in a while, I get like a good January movie like The Gray or...
Selma. That was a January movie.
No, it was a December movie, but we watched it in January.
Oh, yeah, you're right. You're right.
Also, The Book of Eli was a January movie. So every once in a while, there's good January movies, but usually not. Batman versus Superman, Dawn of Justice.
We've talked this one to death.
I mean...
But good God, I mean, like, if you want to talk about fan reaction, before any of the trailers came out, every little anything we could get our hands on was just like, oh my God, this is going to be amazing. Oh my God, look at this. Oh, this is new. Oh my God. And then the trailer came out and people were like, I'm going to hold out hope. I really hope this is okay. And then the new trailer came out and everybody was just like, oh, fuck this shit. What the hell are you doing? Besides, just us. Like, I saw one review online somewhere that said, like, oh, it looks epic. But other than that, I haven't heard anybody, like, look at the
new
trailer
in the
and say
theaters.
It looks good.
Except people who don't know anything about the fucking...
That was the only time.
Any people who don't know anything about Doomsday.
Well, the only thing when we were in theaters that people were, like, freaking out over was fucking Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
Fucking not Wonder Woman. Fucking scrawny woman. Like, what the...
Yeah.
And I've heard some people bitch online, like, oh, you... Not to me specifically, but, like, in general, just like, oh, people are giving her shit because she's she doesn't, like, because of her race, you know, like, she looks Mediterranean. Well, Wonder Woman isn't supposed to be white. It's not that. She's scrawny as shit. They didn't even CGI muscles on her. Like, what the hell?
Yeah.
And you picked a shit actress, and, like, she's just gonna look pretty. And that's what they do in every fucking Zack Snyder movie. What Zack Snyder movie has a decent female? Lena Headey. Because, like, you can't fuck up with Lena Headey. But other than that one example, what's one decent female in a Zack Snyder film?
One of the owls in the owl movie.
Oh, no,
the
not the
Guardians of Ga'Hoole. Yeah.
Okay, I didn't see that, and I won't
The mom in that movie was good.
No, I'm not going to see that movie.
No, you should see it. It's good.
No. I don't like fucking Soren.
Okay.
I really don't fucking like Soren, and I really liked that series when I was a kid, and I fucking hate Soren in the trailer, so I'm like, no. But, that being said, just, like, you have fucking Gina Carano, and if you're really gonna pick between two, like, not great actresses, at least go with the one who's better to look at.
Yeah.
Who the fuck is gonna, like, look at between Gal Gadot and Gina Carano and, like, really pick Gal Gadot?
Yeah, plus she has, like, okay, forgive me, I'm gonna sound sexist right here, but, like, okay, so you got a woman who can fight and has tits and ass.
And a gorgeous smile to boot.
And a gorgeous smile, a gorgeous face, all this fucking shit.
She's beautiful.
And then,
she's got
and then you got
hair,
a chick,
face,
you got a chick that
body.
Literally probably would break her leg walking on the runway in high heels.
Yeah. Yeah. And they made
But she was in the Iranian army. Who the fuck isn't in the Iranian army?
Well, I don't really care about that so much as I've seen her do. Because
everybody
combat.
Has to fucking
no.
go to the fucking army
no, I know,
in that
but
country.
Like, even besides that, I've seen her do action film scene. And it was terrible. Hey, and but she was bad.
She doesn't even have to do that shit because they're just going to fucking CGI this shit.
No, they're not even going to CGI it. She's just going to hold up her shield. And that's all she's going to fucking do.
Also, like, when the fuck has Wonder Woman had a shield?
Well, because, like, they got to hide her, you know? She can't actually fight. She has a shield just to do
She has a sword and shield. That doesn't remind me of Wonder Woman. She fights with a fucking whip. She fights brawler style, too. Well, like, she fights with her hands most of the time.
To be fair, I wonder...
She
can
kick Superman's ass. Like, she's fought Superman.
No, I agree.
And now she's fucking dating Superman, too.
And I know, and that just always grosses me out. Yeah. I fucking hate that. I see, like, these comic book covers with the two of them making out. I'm like, what the fuck, you guys? Ew, get a room.
Oh, my God.
Ugh. Like, right there on the covers. Hey, like, but... Ew.
Hey. If I were Superman and I had to choose between Lois Lane or Wonder Woman...
Oh, well, no, duh. But, like, my point is about the sword and shield. If you're really going into, like, Amazon theory, which is what they were doing with the costume, at least. Like, this Amazon mythology, and you go with the
you
sword
You mean
and
the
shield.
Xena costume?
Yeah. I mean, I like the costume. Whatever.
Yeah.
But if you're going to go closer to that, I can understand, like, adding the sword and shield and taking away the invisible airplane. You know. You're not really going to go that close to the original source material.
I mean, that's probably my favorite thing that that Megan Fox said when she was talking about Wonder Woman. She was like,
"The invisible plane is dumb. That's why I turned it down." You know, and whatever the fuck. Megan Fox is not very likable.
I'd probably like her better as Wonder Woman than Gal Gadot.
Oh, I saw Gal Gadot in the trailers, and I'm like, Megan Fox, can we please have you back? Oh. No, but really what it looks like with the shield is they're trying to look for an excuse for her not to fight.
Yeah.
So they give her a shield instead.
Yeah. All right, another movie that I will probably... another movie that I'm just going to say is going to be bad. Ghostbusters.
Wait, what? That's not on your list. I thought you were going to go with Space Jam 2.
Well, yeah, let's talk about Space Jam 2 then.
Okay.
LeBron James... Space Jam.
Well, here's the other thing, too.
Yeah.
I know people... Okay, you were talking about, like, nostalgia.
Oh, yeah.
People who love something for the sake of being nostalgic.
Yeah.
I remember growing up with Space Jam and thinking it was garbage as a child. I did not have particularly great taste as a child. And I looked at this and
well,
I was like,
to
this
be
is
fair,
shit.
To be fair, I liked it when I was a child because I was a fan of Michael Jordan at the time. And...
He's boring as hell in that movie. Like, there's nothing.
But
like
I was a fan of Michael Jordan, the icon.
No, back I know,
then.
But like,
and like I had my mom like bought me like a documentary of Michael Jordan, and I would like watch. That was the only time that I actually like watched sports like religiously. Like I was just like Michael Jordan's fucking amazing. Like
it's adorable.
This guy is an artist when it comes to fucking dunking.
Yeah.
And like when it came to like playing basketball, like. Really, nobody can touch him, like, as far as that goes. So, like, yeah, I watched the movie, and, like, I enjoyed it. Plus, like, Bill Murray was funny in the movie, so.
To be fair, part of the reason why I really hated it was because I watched the Looney Tunes all the time. Once a week, I was able to go over to somebody's house where I could
Looney
watch
Tunes
television.
Now?
No, this is a new Looney Tunes. This is before the new Looney Tunes came out. And I used to go over to somebody's house where I could watch TV there, and this happened once a week. And I would start watching... at about 7 p.m., and I would not stop watching TV until about 9 a.m. I would stay up all night watching TV, and it was all these oldies Looney Tunes. That's pretty much it. And it was Looney Tunes and Animaniacs and Tiny Toons. And
did you watch it when they would, like, repeat the same episode for, like, an hour?
And no, it, was, like, the, it wasn't that bad.
No,
it,
I
mean,
swear
no,
it was that
they
bad.
They used to do this, but, like, when
but
I would
sometimes
watch it...
sometimes it would be, like, the one segment. It would be, like, one Looney Tunes cartoon that's, like, what? Like, 8 minutes
it's
or something
long,
like that?
Just repeat it. Yeah. No, I remember that happening, but this didn't happen, like, once a week every night when I was watching TV at this point in time. I don't know. Not to my recollection, anyway. But I used to watch this religiously, and then I would watch Space Jam, and I'm like... What the fuck is this garbage? What about Looney Tunes?
Yeah.
So. Fuck Space Jam. I'm not gonna say I'm sorry. I'm not fucking sorry. Fuck that shit. Yeah. And if you like that shit, you can like it, but like, I'm not gonna like it.
Alright, so my next one is Ghostbusters. Yeah, I didn't put it on my list, but like... Okay. Here's the thing. I understand that like... You want to, like, reboot the series. And, like, I also understand that, like, you know, you might want to have some women in the movie, you know, to give it, like, a mixed cast. But not completely replace the characters with essentially, like, oh, these are the exact characters from the old movie. You have your Bill Murray character. You have who I'm going to say is probably Melissa McCarthy. Then you have your Dan Aykroyd character, Kristen Wiig. Mm-hmm. Then whatever the, you have your, the guy with the glasses.
I know who you're talking about, but yeah, I can't remember
have
what you're saying.
You have that character who's being replaced by, you know, a woman. And then you have, what was the black guy's name?
I feel really bad because I used to know this. And I can't remember his name right now.
Yeah. Well, you have that actor, too, who's been replaced by a black woman. So you literally took the exact same character archetypes. You know, even if they're different characters, you took the exact same archetypes and, you know, made Ghostbusters with women. Congratulations.
Can you do something better than that, please? That's all, yeah, that's all exactly. I fucking want. I'm not even against, like... I'm not against an all-female movie. That's fine.
I wouldn't be surprised if this is like a remake with fucking Stay Puft Marshmallow Man and everything.
Well, here's the thing. Like, I obviously don't have an issue with this because I like a lot of female comedy. Like, for example, Bridesmaids. That's an original story and you have, you know, the better characters and it's not like a stupid cash grab. And, you know, if you write it in mind to have an all-female cast, that's fucking fine. But this is just like, why? Why can't you make new characters? Or why can't... Like, pitch them your idea. Your idea was a lot fucking better, where it was like, oh, well, we're going to train up new Ghostbusters and have a whole bunch of new Ghostbusters, and they can at least be their own fucking people, you know?
I also predict that this is going to be like Gem and the Holograms type thing. You know, except this is a much...
No, there's a lot of hype for the Ghostbuster movie.
There really is?
No, there's a lot of hype for the new
Ghostbusters movie. Why? Because, like... I mean, I understand, like, you know, you talked about the thing that I was saying, you know, I was worried about, like, Star Wars, you know, trying to, like, throw the progressive thing. Now, this is, like, literally
right
saying...
Right down to the secretary being a dude.
Yeah, I mean, it's literally, you know, you take the exact same fucking script and you gender swap it. What the fuck?
Well, I don't know why you... Close your eyes, close your ears for a minute. You can't hear this part. I don't know why, because he hasn't finished Buffy. I don't know why you don't just do a Buffy thing where you don't have more Ghostbusters. You don't have the original four anymore, so grow it into, like, a new Enterprise and just have, like, a bunch of new Ghostbusters and just have them be their own people. That's fucking fine. And I tapped Ryan and let him take his fingers out of his ears. But that was his pitch that he told me, and I was like, because I didn't really like the idea of the Ghostbusters thing either, but then he told me that, and I was like, God damn, that's a much better idea. That's a much better way to involve more diversity in your film if that's really something you need. But that's better than just cut, copy, paste boobs on top of the old characters.
And I'm not even sure that they didn't do that. But, like, at the same time, like...
But that's what they're marketing it as. That's what they want people to think it is. And it's just like, why?
I guarantee you could probably get more asses in seats if you got Dan Aykroyd and, Bill Murray to come back.
Right, and you had them alongside.
I mean, you can't get Rick Moranis because Rick Moranis
doesn't want to do it.
Doesn't want to do it, but, like, you know, you can get the people who are... Harold Ramis, that was the other guy that I couldn't remember his name. But, like, you know, you can't get him because he's dead, unfortunately. But you can get, like, the other people, and, like, hopefully they show fucking cameos. But, like, this seems to be a fucking... I mean, this seems to be Anita Sarkeesian at her fucking high point, like saying, here, we're going to take your fucking movies. We're going to change what you know and love. And instead of, like, doing something different, you know, which is, like, possibly, like, okay, this is a branch or, you know, something like that, we're literally taking the exact same archetype and making it women. Well, and we can't even fucking call ourselves, like, a different movie or anything like that. But apparently they're coming out with a guy version, too, which it's like, why?
Wait, a guy version of what?
Ghostbusters.
Why not put them in the same fucking movie?
Exactly, that's my whole fucking thing. Like,
we're not a Southeast Asian pop band! Just put them together!
Yeah, exactly. Like, I don't fucking know. But, like, Anyway, so that's my deal with that movie. Like, what the fuck?
Just like, why?
And it might be good, it might be bad. I'm predicting it's going to be bad, and I'm going to predict that it's going to be a... I'm going to predict that it makes money, but it's not going to make as much money as they wanted because they did that. Mm. All right, and so another movie that I have on my list...
I've heard people actually compare the response from the new Star Wars movie to the response from the Ghostbuster movie.
Oh, that she's a Mary Sue and everything like that?
No, it was some particular meme, and I didn't agree with it at all, but I'm trying to remember what it was. It was like, they were talking about Force Awakens, where it's like, oh, you kept everything exactly the same, and you didn't do anything new and different. And then with Ghostbusters, oh, you changed everything, and I want it to be the exact same as my childhood. And it's like, that's not the problem with Ghostbusters. The problem is...
Like, it is the exact same
thing. You didn't make it different. You didn't make it different enough.
Yeah. I mean, the only thing you did is like take out the dicks, which is kind of funny because like that's the funny line from Ghostbusters where they're like, "Oh, dickless over here." Mm-hmm. That's right. He has no dick. You know, which is funny because like that might be a line in the movie. Like, as a callback to that, but that's, like, the only joke that I can think with
the cast. They could only make that joke about Melissa McCarthy.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying anything personal about her. That's her sense of humor.
Yeah. I have no dick?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, like, I could totally see Melissa McCarthy being like, you should write that joke about me. And I will say, I still think it's fucking weird seeing her go from Gilmore Girls to... everything she's doing now. It's fucking weird. And I'm not saying it's bad. It's not bad at all. It's just really bizarre.
But also, like, what is it about fat people that's funny? Like, why do fat people always have to be the funny people?
I don't know, because in Gilmore Girls, she really wasn't the fat one. She was the best friend, but she was really pretty, and she had her own character and, you know, all that stuff. It's like, that's not the type of person she was in the thing, and then she was gone for forever, and then she came back, and like, this is the new her, and I'm like, whoa!
To be fair with guys, it's a little bit different, because, you know, with women, it's you're either gross or you're funny.
Right. And
with guys, it's either, well, it's one of three things. You're either gross, funny, or gangster.
Well, to be fair, this is actually something I'm really liking in female comedy now, especially if you look at stuff like Broad City, where I like the fact that they're treating women less like, oh, but they have to be so beautiful and perfect and whatever the fuck, and they can just be people. Like, Amy Schumer doesn't do this as much as, like, Broad City, but there's, like, this joke on Broad City where it's like, oh, you're in the shower and you think you have this long hair on your ass, but then you realize that... you washed your hair and it fell into your ass. And I'm like, oh my god, that's so fucking true. You know? I know. Out of context, no. I mean, it's... that's exactly what it sounds like. But it's cool. It's refreshing to see girls who, like, just are people. That's it. They're not, like, particularly boyish. They're not particularly gross. And they're not particularly girly. They're just doing their own thing. And Melissa McCarthy is not doing that at all. But I thought she was hilarious in Bridesmaids. I've seen... no, I didn't see Tammy, but other than that, I've seen all of her movies pretty much just to see the Melissa McCarthy movies, and I'm okay with what she's doing. It's fine. I worry sometimes that she thinks she has to get bigger in order to be funny, but, I mean, if that's not the case, that's fine, but that's something also, that happens a lot with comedians.
She's also been, like, gaining size, and, like, I don't mean this in a fat-shaming way. It feels like she's actually being
pressured to be bigger.
Yeah.
In the same way that, like, women are pressured to be thinner.
Yeah.
They just see, like, oh, you suddenly became really successful for being the fat chick, so do that more. And
Look at Jonah Hill. Like, he lost weight.
Exactly, yes.
He actually lost weight for himself.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're like, oh, that's not funny. You're not funny. And so he gained it back. Like, what the fuck, people?
Yeah. I just hope, like, she's doing okay in her personal life with that. That's all I'm going to say.
Yeah. Yeah, because, I mean, it's a health thing. I mean, look at Chris Farley or John Candy. I mean, they were bigger actors, and they died because of it. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I mean, I don't want that to happen to her, because I do think that she's talented. I mean, I think that she's making some poor choices right now as far as, like, you know, being typecasted, but... All right, and the last film is Martyrs, which you don't know anything about, but it's a fucking American remake of a film that's too disturbing to make an American remake for, which they'll have all the fucked up stuff, but they won't have any of the profound stuff, and that's pretty much it.
Okay.
All right, so let us know what you think in the comments below.
But then we got really sober about that. It's a sobering topic, though. I mean, especially because, like you said, we're not, like... It's not a fat-shaming thing. It's not really about what she looks like, but... America has an obesity problem. We all fucking know it. And a big part of it is... There are a lot of contributing factors, one of which is the food industry in America.
Yeah.
That's a big fucking issue. The food that people have access to in grocery stores, in fast food restaurants, it's garbage. And it's doing garbage things to our bodies.
Yeah. Also, the body...
And you know that firsthand, being out of America for a really long time.
Also, the body positivity movement, which, you know, say what you will about it. I understand people are beautiful, whatever. Everybody knows what unhealthy is. They do. You don't have to... You don't have to explain it to people. People know what unhealthy is. You can feel unhealthy.
Yeah.
That's all I'm going to say about that. But I will say that, like, you don't hear guys talking about positive, large body stuff often.
For example...
You don't. I'm just saying, you don't.
No, I understand. But, like, for example, I am not worried about Meghan Trainor's health.
Well, yeah.
She looks fine.
Okay, but there's a difference between, like, thick and, like, you know.
No, but that's what I'm saying. It's not a thing of, like, oh, you have to be skinny to be healthy. You have to look like the Yolandi from Dying in order to look healthy. It's not like that.
That doesn't look healthy.
No, it doesn't look. But, I mean, like, some people are naturally like that, whatever. Human beings come in a variety of shapes and sizes. Mm. You can be naturally very skinny. Mm. You can sometimes be naturally skinny to the point where people worry about you and say you need to eat more, and that might not be the case.
Yeah, you just might, like, have, like, a high metabolism, that happens.
Yeah, you might be the kind of person where you work out and you eat right, and, you know, you have muscle and you do all the right things, and you don't have that body. No. You don't look skinny, and you just look... But you don't look unhealthy, that's the thing. Then there's...
Precious.
You know, I wasn't even going to say that because I was going to go into, like, a personal anecdote. Then there's to the point where when I worked at Sonic, there was a man who came every lunch hour, every day, to Sonic. There was no separation between him and the steering wheel. And he had an oxygen tank that he was hooked up to in the seat next to him. And he was eating Sonic every day. You clearly are not healthy. You have medical equipment next to you that you need to get by on a day-to-day basis. But I'm not saying, like, it's his fault for doing that, because I don't know anything about him, and, you know, what the fuck do you have access to that's better, honestly? You know, American food industry is fucking horrible. There's a reason why other countries besides Canada won't accept our food.
Yeah, and, like... Like, I'm not kidding. You could go to another country, eat the exact same fucking thing that you're eating now, and I guarantee you, you'd lose, like, 10 pounds.
Yeah.
I'm not even kidding you. Just go there for, like, 6 months. Watch the weight go away. Don't even change your habits.
And a big part of it is just America is a country that's built on, we need to make money from the people who really shouldn't be being robbed right now. And a lot of that shows up in the food service industry, where you've got factory farming being so fucking prevalent while they're trying to shut down organic self-sustaining farming that can reach FDA approval.
Yeah.
You know, you've got that fucking going on in our country where they're like, oh, you do whatever your own fucking food and you can pass all our standards and get all our certification, and we're still going to shut you down because we don't want you taking our money from... You know, I'm really not going to get all super into the factory farming, mostly because it's really gross. I mean, I could say some stuff, but if you're eating or something, or you're easily persuaded to feel nauseated or anything, I don't really want to get that into it. But, like, if you're interested, I mean, there's a shit ton of stuff you can figure out about it.
Also, I'll say if anybody is overweight, It's kind of like quitting smoking. You, like, you know, and yeah, you could have health issues. You could have health issues and all that kind of stuff. And it's like, if you have health issues, you can eat better. Like, simple.
No. I'm literally going to fight you on this. It's not that simple because there are there are physical health issues. There are mental health issues. And there is the food service industry where even people who try to do the right thing
But moderation, that's one thing.
I know what you mean, but like there are things that have to be addressed, and I'm not saying I'm going to be like, oh, no matter what you do, you're perfectly fine the way you are. I mean, there is unhealthy
like
stuff.
Personality-wise, but like health-wise.
But there's never going to be a situation where it's like, oh, you can just fix that.
Easy.
And
I mean,
it's a person-by-person basis.
And there's certain levels where like you're kind of fucked. But like,
I mean, like genetics play a part, and like I said, there's physical health, there's mental health, there's what you can even get your hands on.
Also, the labor industry. I mean, like, how many fucking jobs do you sit on your fucking ass and work your ass off, but you don't get off your ass?
Right.
So.
No, I agree. And I mean, it's just the shit that's available. You know, actually good, healthy food. Even stuff that's not even that much healthier, but, you know, people can claim it or whatever the fuck. It's too expensive. Fast food is fucking expensive nowadays. You can't really go to a fast food restaurant and get a meal for less than $9.
Hey, but Trader Joe's has little packs that are under $5.
No, I know Trader Joe's, but not everybody like goes to Trader Joe's. There are certain places that are like food deserts where that's just not what's available to you. That's not a place you can go shopping to. You know, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
These are real fucking issues.
Food is
not being provided to every person. And I don't even, I mean, like, decent food, real food, stuff that has, like, actual nutritional value.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about potato chips. And I'm not gonna, like, I fucking love potato chips and I will eat them all the time. But I have had days where that was my dinner because that's what I could get. I've had months where I've had to eat out of vending machines because that's what I could do, or eat out of a convenience store.
I saw this comic that was so funny.
That's what you can do.
I saw this comic that I could really relate to because, like, I've been at a point where I just didn't have money, and it's like, have you ever been so broke that the only food that you had was sleep?
But I mean, like, What's something that the joke is every college student just goes and gets ramen. Ramen is not fucking food. That's not nutritional. That's not sustainable.
No.
But
it just fills
have
you
I
up.
Fucking done that? Of course I have, because that's what I can afford.
No.
That's the best meal I can get out of the vending machine at work sometimes, and I can't afford anything more.
Yeah. And we're definitely not making money on this podcast.
Well, I mean, that's not why we do it. That's not the point.
No.
But, you know, it's...
Yeah, just because we have ads on it, and like you have to make like
a certain amount to make to start
anything.
Making a
yeah.
cent to make a penny, you have to make a certain amount for YouTube. YouTube's I'm not gonna say it because it could take our video down. Never mind. Fucking authoritarian regime. What? Anyways, that was all I was trying to say. Is
hey,
like
our podcast is over 10 minutes, so they don't pay attention.
Oh.
And
yeah.
We don't have copyrighted music in this podcast, so...
Yeah, that's true. And I mean, as long as you don't use video clips and all that, whatever.
Which I sometimes do, which...
We just went on, like, a whole tangent about, like, politics and health and whatever the fuck, but we didn't mean to, but,
It looks like a good year, it looks like a shit year, and it looks like a year that you can be both enthusiastic and avoid... Some of the films that we mentioned, and be skeptical about some of the others. And if there are any other films that you find interesting, if you disagree with us, let us know in the comments below or email us at allwalksoffilm@gmail.com. That's no spaces. And we'd love to hear from you. And like one of these days we'll do like a response video. So.
Yeah, because I mean... We really should specifically say, because I know we say it like from time to time, but there are some comments that everybody has to deal with shit comments, obviously. There's whatever. It's the internet. You do whatever. But then there are people who really make an effort and they say something very heartfelt and kind, or they at least say something Not at least, because that makes it sound like, no, this is a really big deal. They say something very thoughtful. Yeah. Something that they've very well thought out. And not always even agreeing with us, so that's not the point to, like, oh, you agree with us. But they take the time to be like, well, I listen to your podcast and I understand what you're saying. And in response, this is what I think. And we don't always say it on the podcast, even though we keep saying we want to. Part of it is just finding an appropriate time and place, which is not now, but we're going to do it anyway. You know, we read every comment, usually multiple times, and, you know, we see them. It's really important. You know, I personally, you know, I get really touched when people, not like that. No, but, you know, when people take the time to really make a, you know, make a point of, hey, I want you to know what I think. I want to know what people think. I think that's really kind for people to do. And there are certain people who have said very, very nice things about our podcast, and I really appreciate it. You know?
Yeah, and I mean, and there's also nothing wrong with, like, disagreeing with us or anything like that. Like,
no, of course not.
Like, I don't think that, you know, we're not the authoritarian, like, you know, and I don't think any critic should be, like, the authoritarian.
Well, also, like, I mean, we're freaking amateurs who get online and do it for fun, and sometimes we have research and sometimes we don't, but we're really just here to, like, talk to people and that kind of stuff. So just because you disagree with us on anything doesn't mean we're going to be like, oh, well, fuck you, or, oh, we hate you, or even laugh about you behind your back. It really is not like that, you know. You have seen, like, with the way that we talk about certain people, that if we were going to laugh at someone, we would do it to their faces. But
yeah, I mean, I've seen some comments that try to be, like, overly negative, and sometimes it's kind of hilarious when they don't know what they're talking about.
Or at least they can't actually have a discussion.
Yeah, like, where they're just like, blah, 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 fuck you, done.
Yeah, and they're like... And then when we try to respond and be like, oh, so what do you mean by this? Or can you explain more about this? They're going to be like,
whoa, whoa,
no.
Whoa, fuck you, done.
Yeah. They're going to be like, no.
Yeah.
You know, it's just like, well, how are we supposed to have a discussion when you're not discussing?
Because,
you know, so the people who do.
Because there's a troll in the dungeon.
Well, of course, and even there's nothing you can do about that. But for the people who, whether you agree or you don't, or you like us or you don't, who, you know, make a point of talking to us, we appreciate that. That's how
course,
you grow.
And of course, there are always going to be trolls. I mean, you know.
Whatever.
Like, we wouldn't be a podcast if we didn't have dislikes and trolls.
Right. I mean, I'm not going to get up on my pedestal and cry every time somebody calls me an autistic bitch, you know. Whatever.
Yeah.
People are going to have their opinions and be vocal about it.
To be fair, we were talking negatively about some aspects of anime, and people are...
Oh, like, I don't... Whatever.
Okay.
It's fine.
Yeah.
I'm still not going to, like... Oh, boo-hoo, poor me. That's what everybody on the internet has to deal with. It's not a big deal. But I think what is a big deal is the people who, you know, really try to reach out and be like, hey,
yeah.
I like you. Oh, hey, I don't really agree with this part, and this is why. And, oh,
yeah.
I see what you did here, and this is cool. You know, who really try to...
Yeah.
You know, we keep saying, oh, well, we want comments, and we want discussion, and we see that, and we want more.
Yeah.
So, that's fucking great, you guys.
All right, so keep it up, guys. Thanks for listening.